This is Atlas Launch Control. We're now 23 minutes, 33 seconds into the mission. Flight of the Atlas V and the Cygnus module now on its way toward a rendezvous with the International Space Station. Vern, I wonder if you could give us a quick snapshot of what you saw as the rocket went uphill. How did it look in terms of the flight of the Atlas and the Centaur and the orbit that we're in?
It was a beautiful launch, George. Everything was very nominal. I can tell you that the for the Atlas booster phase of flight, the Atlas booster performed slightly above nominal, so that's a good thing. The predicted times of when events occurred were very close to the the actual times were very close to the pre-flight predictions. I can tell you that booster engine cutoff occurred within a tenth of a second of our prediction. And main engine cutoff, when we inserted the Cygnus module into orbit, was within 2 seconds of the pre-flight predictions, which is well within the expected variation. Looks like we nailed the orbit once again. And in a few minutes, we'll go off and get our initial look at the data. But at this point, everything looks very nominal. Looks like a very accurate orbit insertion. I know that the spacecraft folks are getting some data from the spacecraft right now. It looks good, and they're going to have full comm in about 5 or 6 minutes from now, and we're looking forward to hearing from them how things are going.
We're just, as a matter of interest, the Centaur now, to complete the mission of the Atlas V and United Launch Alliance, has some things to do.
Yes, exactly. So as soon as we separate, we immediately begin what we call a CCAM maneuver. That's a collision and contamination avoidance maneuver. The idea is to back away from the spacecraft so that there's no chance of recontact and so that there's no possibility of contamination from the small maneuvering thrusters that we have on Centaur. Now, about a half an hour after separation, I think it's about 27 minutes, we will actually do another short engine burn. It'll last about 11 or 12 seconds, and the reason we're doing that is to do a controlled deorbit of the Centaur upper stage, and that will bring the stage down just a little over an hour after liftoff. So what's that? Probably about close to half an hour from now. It'll bring it down south of Australia over open water, and that's a planned deorbit so that you never have to worry about orbital debris from this upper stage again. So once we're done with that, our launch vehicle mission will be complete. But of course, the primary mission to deliver Cygnus to orbit looks like it has been successful, and we'll get confirmation of that shortly.
Well, Vern, congratulations on a successful launch, and I know we very much have enjoyed having the Orbital Cygnus ATK people here at Kennedy and processing through Kennedy facilities. They really have been very enjoyable to work with, and hopefully they'll come back and bring us another module at some point in the future as well.
Yeah, we look forward to doing it again. They're a great team to work with. I love working with them, and I hope we can all do it again soon.
Exactly right. Yep, they're a super payload test team. So, well, Vern, thanks very much. We'll look forward to seeing you on the post-launch news conference later on. But again, thank you and congratulations on what appears to be at this point as a very successful launch for the Atlas V.
Okay, thank you, George. We'll see you in a while.
And we're now 27 minutes, 10 seconds into the flight of the Atlas V with Cygnus now on its way to the International Space Station.